So now, coming to getting the hacked message. Now, using over here the hack transposition cipher function, we start with a couple of print statement there. Okay, that is, we are saying print hacking, then printing a press Control C on Windows, okay, or a Control D on Mac OS and Linux to quit at any time. After this, now, because the program may try many keys, okay, and the program displays a message telling the user that the hacking has started and that it might take a moment to finish the process. So the print command over here tells the user to press a Control C on Windows or D on Linux or OS to exit the program at any point. Okay. Now you can actually press these keys to exit any running Python program on the particular given operating system. And after that, the next couple of lines tells the program which key to loop through by specifying the range of possible keys for the transposition cipher. So over here, we run this for loop after that, saying for the key str in the range of 1 till the length of the message str, we are saying print trying the key and the number of the key that it is trying. So the possible keys for the transposition cipher range between 1 and the length of the message. Okay. And the for loop on this particular line tells the hacking part of the function which with each of this particular given keys. So it uses the string interpolation to print the key currently being tested using the string interpolation to provide a feedback back to the user. So using the message that is, or using the function that is demo16.decryptMessageSTR, which is there in our demo16.py program that we have already written, it gets the decrypted output from the current key being tested and stores that particular value in the variable that is decrypted text str. Okay. And the decrypted output in the particular variable decrypted text str will be English only if the current key was used. Otherwise, it would appear as a garbage text. So then the program passes that particular string, okay, or that is decrypted text str into isEnglishCheck function, which is there in our checkEnglish.py. Okay. And then it prints part of the decrypted text str, the key used and the instructions for the user. That is, it asks, first prints a blank line, prints the possible encryption hack, prints the key, again a blank line, and then asks for the response from the user by asking it to press D if it is done. Now, just because the checkEnglish.isEnglishCheck method returns true and moves the execution to the next line, it doesn't mean that the program has found the correct. It could be a false positive, meaning that the program dictated some text as English that is actually a garbage text. So to make sure that it previews the text so the user can confirm that the text is an indeed English, it uses that slice decrypted text str colon 50 to print out the first 50 characters of the. And then the program pauses after the particular line and asks or waits for the user to enter D or anything else. And then stores that input as a string in the given response variable. Okay. Now, understanding the strip string method. Now, when a program gives a user specific instruction, but the user doesn't follow them exactly, an error results. And when our particular program prompts the user to enter D, confirm the hacked message, it means that the program won't accept any input other than D. And if the user enters an extra space or a character along with D, the program won't accept it. So let us look at how to use this strip string method to make the program accept other inputs as long as they are similar enough to D. So the strip string method returns a version of the string with any white space characters at the beginning and end of the string stripped out. Now, the white space characters are the space characters, tab characters, and the new line characters. So for this, we would enter some following text in the interactive shell to see how this basically works. So if we go over here and if we write down here certain space, write down hello, and then we use the strip, still we get only the text that is hello. Or if we write down using, say, some special characters there, dot strip, still it is coming the same way. Or if we try to give space before, okay, and say here dot strip. Now in between the words, the space will be counted, but before and after that would be removed. In the given examples over here, this strip method removes the space characters at the beginning and the end of any two given strings. Okay, so if a particular string includes space in at the beginning or at the end of the string, the method removes them from both the sides, but doesn't remove any space between other characters. Okay, the strip method can also have a string argument passed to it that tells the method to remove characters other than white space from the beginning and the end of the string. Now to see an example for this, say we give over here another example, say write down any characters, or let's write down just one character in this case, say ppp, write down here hello ppp, okay, dot strip, and we give the character p. So it removes p from everywhere. Okay, or suppose we have used say ab everywhere. This is our text. We use here dot strip, say AB. So it removes AB and gives us the given string. Okay, like that way, we can give here the example. Okay, so if you pass a string, arguments say A or AB, remove these characters when they occur at the beginning or the end of the string. Similarly, but the given strip function doesn't remove characters embedded in the middle of the string. So let us see applying the strip string method over in our given program here. Now let's return to the source code and see how to apply the strip in our given program. So after this, if we go below, okay, we are having this if condition over here. Now in this, we are using say if the response dot strip dot upper dot starts with D. Now if the condition for the statement were simply response is equal to capital D, the user would have to enter capital D exactly and nothing else to end the program. For example, if the user enter a small d or some spaces capital D or say D capital done, the condition would be false and the program would continue checking other keys instead of returning the hacked message. So to avoid this issue, the string in the response removes the white space from the start and the end of the string with the call to strip. Then the string that uses a response.strip evaluates to has the upper method called on. Whether the user enter a small d or a capital D, the string returned from the upper will always be capitalized as capital D. So adding the flexibility in the type of the input, the program can accept and make it easier to use. Now to make the program accept user input that starts with D but it is full word, we can use the starts with to check only the first letter. For example, if the user input says space, 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 done as a response, then the white space would be stripped and the string done would be passed to upper. After upper capitalizes the whole string into capital, the string is then passed on to starts with, which returns the true because the string does starts with the substring D. Now, if the user indicates that the decrypted string is correct, the function hack transposition str will return the decrypted text str. Now failing to hack the message. Now for example, if the first line of the for loop that began over here, in that is for key str in the range, if that particular loop has begun and the program execution reaches this point, it means the program has never reached the return statement, which would happen if the correctly decrypted text was never found for any of the keys that were tried. So in that case, it returns none value to indicate the hacking has failed. Okay, so after this, we come to the last part over here, that is we are checking, okay, call to the main function if this program was run by itself rather than being imported by another program using its hack transposition str function. Okay, so remember that the name variable is set by Python and the main function will not be called if your current file, that is transposition hack example, is imported as a module. Okay, so with this, we have understood how the particular program has been created, how does it execute, and what is the output that we are getting from the executed program.